I'm the Homeless Housewife, and my colleagues and I decided we wanted to be part of the Neighbors Go Gives Back program. So we're going to look for a way to help our community.
Hi!
Oh, hi!
Hi there, can I help you?
Well, you wouldn't know a way to help the community, would you?
Well, actually I do. Welcome to CCA. How would you like to help out in the pantry?
That sounds cool.
Okay, come on, let's go. One thing that we try to do here at CCA is not just feed people, mm-hmm. we also try to teach them how to live on a budget. Mm-hmm. They have a certain dollar amount when they come in, a voucher amount mm-hmm. that they use. And we also want them to have nutritional meals. So they come in every week, they have an appointment, and okay. they shop. Our entire pantry is run by volunteers. We have 2.5 staff members that actually run it, and I don't know what we'd do without our volunteers. And we do everything from stocking the shelves to sorting that we have, as we have checking out as well. We also have people, if they want to volunteer, they actually go to grocery stores and they get the bread. The day-old bread, and we're able to put it out here, and it can only be on the shelf a day. But that's another way. We have people that do it every single morning. They do a bread run for us. In the pantry, there are a lot of different jobs, from stacking our jars and our canned goods to breaking down 20-pound bags into family-size packaging. So, and then we have our freezer work. We always have meats for our families. That's the cold job, okay. but it's a great job because we always want to make sure we have nutritious food for our families.
Oh, wow, okay.
We have people that do it every single week on the same day, and then we have people that will do it once a quarter or maybe once a month. So it's wonderful if you are really looking for an opportunity for a church group or a club of some sort to really give on a regular basis.
Yeah.
One thing that I really appreciate that our founders had was the vision to really think big. Mm-hmm. And one way they really thought big was a drive-in freezer. And the reason this is exciting is when we hear a call from Mrs. Paul's and they've got fish sticks, uh-huh. an overabundance, we can take a truck. We can go up and get it, and we can drive it in and put it in. And when we get an overabundance of something, we can barter with other, like we'll give you fish sticks for diapers with other pantries. So what they need, it's just so wonderful that we've got the storage.
And you said volunteers will work in here as
well? Oh, yes, with gloves and hats and scarves. Not quite dressed the way you're
right.
dressed.
Right, I'm not really dressed for this.
No, okay.
I really enjoy it. It feels a lot of joy inside helping people in need, that you can see their faces when they come, sometimes desperate for food, and we just give it to them, and they just live with a smile on their faces, and it's just great. It's a feeling that you cannot experience until you are here, so I'm really happy to be here. I love this place.
There are lots of food pantries in the Dallas-Fort Worth area that are in need of volunteers, and you can be one of them. For information about other food pantries and about CCA, visit neighborsgo.com/helplesshousewife. Happy holidays!